श्री महापति महादेव की जय। डिवोटीज, वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू अवर डिस्कशन ऑन लॉर्ड शिवा। वी विल बिगिन विथ भजन एज वी ग्लोरीफाई भगवान शंकर। पंडित उमेश विल लीड अस एज वी ग्लोरीफाई लॉर्ड शिवा।
जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, करुणा कर करतार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, करुणा कर करतार राशि सुख सार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर। जय शशि शेखर, जय दमरूधर, जय जय प्रेमागार हरे। जय शशि शेखर, जय दमरूधर, जय जय प्रेमागार हरे। जय त्रिपुरा, जय मदहारी, अमित अनंत अपार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, करुणा कर करतार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर। जय रामेश्वर, जय नागेश्वर, वैद्यनाथ केदार हरे। जय नागेश्वर, वैद्यनाथ केदार हरे। काशीपति श्री विश्वनाथ, जय मृत्युंजय अविकार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, करुणा कर करतार हरे। जय कैलाशी, जय अविनाशी, सुख राशि सुख सार हरे। जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर, जय शिव शंकर, जय गंगाधर।
Take a dive into the ocean of Swaha Satsang with the inspirational selections of Bhakti Ras by Paramacharya Pandit Haridev Prasad, Pandit Dr. Umesh Prasad. Receive the grace of Bhagavan Shiva through Bhakti Ras Shiva Bhajans, a compilation of Shiva Stotras, Mantras and Bhajans. Step onto the path of devotion through Bhakti Ras Bhajuragu Parasham, collection of Shri Ram and Krishna bhajans, tunes by Prem Ki Nadiya Jeevan Naiya, a series of specially selected philosophical bhajans that warms the heart of the ardent seeker.
Mahadev ki jai. Devotees, we are looking at Lord Shiva, the form that he carries, as we see, and we are looking at some of the symbols and we interpret what they mean. We have already spoken about his white color, symbolizing his all-pervasive nitya. And we spoke about the three eyes. The Lord sees everything, he is everywhere. Nothing is hidden from him. He knows the past, the present, and the future. Lord Shiva has matted locks, jata. What is the symbolic meaning of this? It is said that there are five main pranvayu, vital airs, and five minor ones, which control all the metabolic activities of the body. So these 10, the five main ones, pran, apan, saman, dhyan, and udan. Inhalation, exhalation, digestive air, fire, so to speak, that air which is all pervasive, and rising air, udan, which had a seat in the throat. And then we are aware of the fact that we blink our eyelids, we burp, we cough, we yawn. Little do we realize that all these little actions that are involuntary are controlled by what we call the pranvayu, the five minor vital airs. They are called Nag, Kurma, Krikar, Dhananjay, and Devdat. So these are the 10 vital airs, five main ones and five minor ones, which control everything that we do. Now, Lord Shiva is in meditation, and he sits in meditation for thousands of years. We should be aware of the fact that because of the various metabolic activities of the body, time and again, the body has to get rid of waste products. We have to answer the calls of nitya, etc. If you have to respond to these different calls of nature and you want to meditate for thousands of years, how practical could that be? So Lord Shiva, by tying the matted locks, the jata on his head, symbolizes the total control, subduing of these 10 vital airs so that the metabolic activities of the body cease. So that one is able to sit undisturbed for long periods of time in meditation. It is symbolic of a great discipline, great control. And we're all aware how difficult it is to have that type of discipline. Even in a simple puja that we do. I want to draw reference to the fact that in today's world, many of our temples, our pujas, our yagyas, even while devotions are in progress, people become very thirsty. They become very hungry. Sometimes they drink while puja is in progress. They drink in the temples. No control. Indiscipline. Not sanctioned by scriptures. You can't mix two things together. So it's a key act as such to control the pranvayu, which control all metabolic activities of the body. It's a discipline. If I don't have that discipline, it is difficult to achieve any further successes spiritually. And while I am mentioning this, from those matted locks flows the Ganga, Mythologically, we are told that Ganga came from the heavenly regions into the here, the matrilocks of Shivaji, who then released this Ganga that flowed to the earthly plane. Hinduism is filled with mythology. Unfortunately, for many of us, we take the mythology to make it the reality. But the mythology reflects certain principles that exist. Ganga, what is Ganga? Yes, there is a holy stream in India which flows from Mount Himalaya. But devotees, in each of us, there should be the Ganga. But what the point we are making, what is Ganga? Ganga is a stream of devotion. Ganga is the stream of devotion. I can go to India and duck in the Ganga how many times I want. I can even live in the Ganga. But if I do not develop that devotion, I am not really bathing, so to speak, in that stream of devotion, that stream of Ganga. Bhakti is what it is. So that Ganga symbolizes a stream of devotion, bhakti. And what is bhakti? Simply put, a pure, unselfish, and unadulterated love for God. A love that gives up everything. And if I may add, asks for nothing in return. This is pure bhakti. Now, put the whole picture together. Shivaji, in one sense, symbolizes the state of vairagya or dispassion. And this is something I would like you to bear in mind. If you understand the point I am making, whether you believe in the form of Shiva or you don't, is irrelevant. Hinduism cuts across all boundaries. The Hindus believe that this is Lord Shiva. Man thinks in images. We understand also that Shiva symbolizes the state of dispassion. So when I look at Shiva, I understand that he symbolizes this wonderful state of dispassion, which cuts across all boundaries. Whether you're a Hindu, Muslim, Christian, whatever you are, you need to have this passion. The sense of tyag, the sense, the ability to give up that which is unnecessary, gravitate towards the reality. And when you have this state of this passion, you have the control over the pran vayu, the body metabolic activities. It's only with such a base, as it were, the stream of devotion can flow. It's simple. But it appears to be simple. Easy to see. But you have to understand that going through all the rituals, going to the church, going to the temple, going to the mosque, and carrying out these various activities, do not in themselves represent a state of devotion. I can do all these things mechanically. But the bhav, the feeling, may not be there. I'm not saying it's not. I'm saying may not be there. And it's quite clear, quite evident, if one has to analyze, if you do not have this passion, if you do not have the control over the bodily functions, then it is very nigh impossible for devotion to develop. And this is one of the reasons why many of the sages you would have heard about, you would have read about, they perform all sorts of sacrifices, various forms of penance, various pilgrimages. You know what the purpose of these actions are? To climb beyond the imperfections of the mind so that you can stabilize yourself, develop that sense of dispassion, and so control bodily functions, and so the stream of devotion will flow. So this is something that has to be understood. When you look at Lord Shiva, as we say, these are some lessons you learn. One picture can say as much as thousands of words. So, just to recap that briefly, the white color, all pervasiveness of Shiva. He is the substratum. He pervades every single atom of creation. He is in me, I am in him. Aham brahmasmi chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham. He sees all things are known to him. Even what is taking place in the deepest recesses of the mind, the darkness of the deepest recesses of the mind, he knows it. Nothing is hidden from him. We cannot fool God. I have to develop that sense of dispassion about me. Tyag, the ability to give up all those things that bind me to this worldly plane, so that I can, you know, take greater control over this body of mine, which is a great vehicle to take me towards that state of liberation. When I can develop this level of discipline, then the Ganga flows. I become absorbed in a stream of devotion. And what else is there except that devotion? Scriptures tell us that is the best stream to take a duck in. So I am saying that I could go to Ganga and duck. I could go to Jamuna and duck. All those are mere rituals. But in a sense, I need to duck in the stream of devotions. And Shivaji, he is the substratum, he is the basis of all devotions. All devotions. We take a few moments to glorify Bhagwan Shankar. Remember, the mind should not stray. The discipline is important. Physical discipline, mental, spiritual discipline is the key. We glorify Shivaji.
हे शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शिव हे शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शिव गिरिजापति भवानी शंकर भवानी शंकर भवानी शंकर गिरिजापति गिरिजापति भवानी शंकर 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 हे शिव शंकर शंभु शिव शंकर शंभु बोलो शिव शंकर शंभु हे शिव शंकर हे शिव शंकर हे शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर नमामि शंकर नमामि शंकर हे शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शंभु हे शिव शंकर नमामि शंकर शिव शंकर शंभु बोलो शिव शंकर शंभु बोलो शिव शंकर शंभु
Devotees, let's concentrate on Shiv Shakti. Ardhanarishwar, that murti of Shiv Shakti, representing, symbolizing that state of non-duality. Namah Parvati Pate Har Har, Har Har Shankar Mahadeva.
ॐ नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
नमः पार्वती पतये हर
ॐ नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
हे हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर 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 महादेव
हर 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 महादेव
बोलो
हर 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 महादेव
ओम शिव 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 सदा शिव
ओम शिव 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 सदा शिव
हे शिव 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 सदा शिव
ओम शिव 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 सदा शिव
ओम हर 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 महादेव
हर 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 महादेव
ॐ शिव 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 सदा शिव
ॐ शिव 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 सदा शिव
ॐ जय हर शिव हर महादेव बोलो
जय हर शिव हर महादेव
ॐ हर शिव शिव हर महादेव बोलो
हर शिव शिव हर महादेव
शिव 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 सदा शिव
ॐ शिव 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 सदा शिव
हे शिव 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 सदा शिव
ॐ शिव 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 सदा शिव
ॐ महादेव सदा शिव
ॐ महादेव सदा शिव
ॐ सदा शिव महादेव
सदा शिव महादेव
ॐ नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
ॐ नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर
नमः पार्वती जगत हे हर
हर हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
हर हर शंकर महादेव
लॉर्ड शिव डिवोटीज हिज व्हीकल इज द बुल नाउ दिस कुड बी क्वाइट laughable for many who don't understand the Hindu culture, the Hindu philosophy, Hindu theology. Again, the animals represent a particular quality. So Lord Shiva rides upon the bull. The bull is a symbol of lust. Lust. Lord Shiva is shown riding on the bull. The bull is under his control. The bull cannot go wherever it wants to go. The bull is controlled by Shiva. Shiva, shown riding upon the bull, is the master of lust. The master of lust. Now, I like to make a clarification. If someone would listen to this statement alone, saying that Shiva is the master of lust, because of our lack of the proper understanding of the English language, not that I know too much also, but I have to make the point, we may conclude that Lord Shiva is good at lusting. There is a difference between master of and master at. Lord Shiva is not the master at lust or lusting. He's the master of, that he is in control. And it goes without saying that whoever worships Shiva is able to bring this dreadful enemy under control. Why? And why not? Shiva is dispassion. When you develop that state of dispassion, then you have that control. And lust, devotees, Chanak Maharaj, in one of his sayings, he said, Trishna vai tarni nadi. Krodho vai vasvato raja, Trishna vai tarni nadi. That Trishna is that river in hell that we call Vaitarni. In Hindu mythology, we speak about that river in hell. We are told that when you die, you all have to cross that river. And, we are told to give a cow down. I won't elaborate upon that. But if you give a cow down, a cow in gift to a holy man, that cow will take you across the river. Now, again, that is, mythology. You have to get the philosophy. Where is hell, devotees? Hell is right here. And what is that river in hell? Vaitarni, lust. Lust. So that what one needs to do, if one worships Shiva, one develops that state of dispassion, so one is able to control that lust. Of course, there are times when lust is necessary. There must be some degree of lust for procreation to take place. But in the path of devotion, you can't have that dominating the mind. And if you look at society today, in many, many places worldwide, the amount of sexual charges being laid against priests and others who are in places of devotion, places of sacrifice, yet they are engaging in illicit sexual activity, lust overpowering them. All religions. All religions. Therefore, they lack that power of dispassion. They need Shiva in their lives more than ever. By worshipping Shiva, I'm able to bring this powerful demon under control. If there's any reason to worship Shiva, at least this is a compelling one. The worship of Shiva, no losses. I want you to bear these points in mind. Panatumesh will lead us as we join together again in the glorification of Bhagavan Shankar.
Har Shiva Shankar Shashank Shekhar हर बम 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 बो भवा भयंकर गिरिजा शंकर धीमी 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 तक नर्तन दे हर शिव शंकर शशंख शेखर हर बम 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 बो I हर शिव शंकर शशंकर शेखर हर बम 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 हर शिव शंकर शशंक शेखर हर बम 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 बो भवा भयंकर गिरिजा शंकर धीमे 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 तक नर तन
शक्ति तुम सची माता